Hello everyone, I am Prashant Kalidas Kaule, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering of KK Wagh Institute of Engineering Education Research, Nashik. So today's topic is directional control valve. In fluid power, we have to control the fluid power. So which are the element which controls the fluid power? So everybody wants control should be in their hand. It should be remote control. So after completing this topic, list the different types of valve used in fluid power. Explain various classification of directional control valve. Describe the working and constructions of various directional control valves. Identify the graphical symbols for various types of direction control valves. So introduction, one of the most important characteristics in fluid power system is control. If control components are not properly selected, entire system does not function as required. In fluid power, controlling element are known as valves. So valves are the fluid power control elements. So types of valve. So there are three categories according to their functions. So first one is known as a direction control valve, which controls the direction of fluid through the circuits. Pressure control valve, which controls the pressure in the circuit. And flow control valves, which controls the flow flowing through the circuits. So there are three aspects: direction of fluid, pressure of fluid, and flow of fluid. So direction control valve. So what is the functions? What is the purpose? They determine the path through which a fluid travels a given circuit. To start, stop, accelerate, deaccelerate, change the direction of motion of hydraulic actuator. To permit the free flow from the pump to reservoir at low pressure when the pump's delivery is not needed in the system. To vent the relief valve by either electrical or mechanical control. So these are the purposes. To isolate a certain branch of the circuit. So we'll go for classification. So first classification, based on the fluid path. So based on that, check valves, shuttle valves, two-way, three-way, four-way valve. Control method. What is the control method of actuation of spool? So it is direct, indirect. And based on the construction of internal moving part, rotary spool type, sliding spool type. So notations for DCV. Each DCV or any valve can be represented by a square. Each individual switching position shown by a square. Flow path is indicated by the arrow. Close position means it does not allow flow from one port to another port. So if there are two squares, it is mean by two position. If there are three squares, it means three position. So what are the methods for DCV actuations? So we want to operate the DCV. Somewhere there should be starting point. So we require some force. So what is that force? Force is applied with the help of some mean. So solenoid operated DCV, pilot operated DCV, manual operated, push button type. So these are their symbols, ISO symbols. So foot pedal operated DCV, pilot operated solenoid, two position return, spring return. So these all are the methods of the DCV actuation. So in exam question may be asked, what are the methods of DCV actuations? So we'll go with first check valve. It is also known as a non-return valve. Just observe the figure carefully. It contains on the valve body, which is a hollow in shape, a cylinder. In that, there is some port, inlet port and exhaust port, and these ports are restricted by some element. That element is known as a ball, which is operated by the spring. So this ball blocks the passage. So when the fluid come under this pressure, it overcomes the spring tension, it pushes the ball and the fluid flow from left hand side to the right hand side. So what is the symbol? Symbol is like this. So flow moving from this side to this side means from the left hand side to right hand side. It does not allow reverse flow. Check wall. Again, the graphical or geometrical shape of the restrictor has been changed. There spherical is there, now it's a wedge shape. Okay, so what is the difference? Difference is the geometry and performance. So reliability of this check wall, puppet operated check wall, it's somewhat good compared to the spherical type. Okay, leakages are less. Pilot operated check wall. What is mean the pilot operated check wall? So consider, if there is no, it will operate when the pilot comes, pilot signal comes from the some other mean, from the third party. For example, consider this one. Now this, when pilot signal is no pilot signal, that time it will act as a normal check wall. So what is a normal check wall? It will allow the flow in only one direction. Now what is the flow direction? From top to bottom. If reverse flow from the bottom to top or downside to upside, it does not allow. But in some special situations, if pilot signal is given, it will allow. Pilot signal is given, so what will happen? This spool will move the, open the wall, and the flow in the reverse direction is possible. So this is the exact working of the pilot operated check wall. So this is a symbol, normal check wall, and this is pilot line. So shuttle wall. So just observe this carefully. What is exactly the construction? Construction is nothing but this is a wall body. There are two inputs, P1 and P2, and there is only one output, A. And restricted is a ball type. If one input is coming, so it will give the output. If second input is coming, it will give the output, and both coming, so it will also give the output. The ball will remain at the center, flow will flow from P1 to A, P2 to A. Okay, so it will act as a shuttle wall. It is also known as the OR wall. 1 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 0 0. So this is exactly symbol. So 2 by 2. So what is meant by 2 by 2? Two way, two position. Two way means two ports, and two positions means it has a two working conditions. So just observe this. This is the wall body. P stand for the pressure port, A stand for the actuator port. Now P and A port has been closed. So what is the position? Normally closed. When we are push, so what will happen? The A port will be open and flow diverted from A to P. Hence, this is exactly the symbol. Now, this is exactly opposite. So, this is a 2x2 DCV normally closed. Why normally closed? In non-operating condition, the ports are closed. Now, this is 2 DCV normally open. What is the normally open? During the non-operating condition, pressure port and actuator ports are connected. When we want to disconnect, we have to apply the force and this will disconnect. Application of 2x2 DCV. So consider this is a tank which we have to fill. So this is a tank, pump, pressure relief valve, and this is a 2x2 valve. So it's normally open, hence flow is diverted towards the tank and it is filling. Now second wall is used to drain the vessel. So it is normally closed. If you want liquid, then we are operating wall 2 2x2 and it's used for draining. So when it is pushed, liquid will move from this side to this side. So 3x2, what is my 3x2? First number indicate 3 ports. What are the ports? Pressure port, tank port, actuator port, PAT. Okay, so it is normally P port is blocked and there is a connection between A and T. So this is normally closed valve. Opposite to that, normally open. What is normally open? P port and A port are connected, tank port is blocked. So application, we can operate a double acting cylinder with the help of 3x2 valve. So extension and retraction is possible with the help of 3x2 valve, but we require 2 valves. This is the condition. So first, if you see, there is a retraction of cylinder will be happen from this side, liquid will be enter from this side, and whatever the liquid, it is connected to the tank, so there is less resistance. Next time we are pushing these two buttons of DCV, and that time liquid will move from this side and it will extend whatever the liquid, it is coming towards the tank. So extension and retraction of four double acting cylinder with the help of 3x2 valve is possible. Now 4x2 valve. What is a 4x2 valve? 4 stand for the 4 port. So this valve body has a 4 ports. What are the naming convention? Pressure, tank, actuator A side, actuator B side. So what is the condition? P is connected to B, that's why P is connected to B, and A is connected to tank. A is connected to the tank. Now next time when it is operated, what is happened? P is connected to A, P is connected to A, and B is connected to T. So application of 4x2 valve. So controlling a double acting cylinder is possible with the help of 4x2 valve. So in this figure, the 4x2 valve is shown and pump is continuously pumping the fluid, and fluid is moving toward the rod end side, and whatever the fluid in the cap end side, it is connected to the tank, less minimum resistance. So what is happen? Cylinder is extended, sorry, the cylinder is retracted. Next time when you move to the left hand envelope, now left hand envelope of the 4x2, so what is happen? Fluid flow in this cap end side, and whatever the fluid, it is coming to the tank. Okay, so this is the control. So we can, this is a double acting cylinder. Now this is a motor, okay, double acting motor. So there is no stalling in the motor because it is continuously rotating either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So these are the references. If you like this video, like it. Also, please subscribe my YouTube channel, pressing the bell icon, never miss the update. Thank you.